Welcome and thank you for joining us. I'm joined today by Darcy Banyala, Alan Horn and Diego Milano, all regulators and GSR alumni. My name is Stephen Barrow. I'm deputy to the director of the BDT and also a former regulator, GSR alumni. How have you seen the role of regulators and policymakers change over the past 20 years?
From 2000, the first GSR, the regulator's focus was very much interconnection, carrier pre-selection. It is very much creating competition, trying to create an even playing field, wholesale regulation, retail regulation. We've come an awful long way from there. The regulator's scope has significantly increased. The skills required in the regulator are very different. And it's a very different animal, but the principles remain the same of consumer protection, independence, fostering healthy competition, and technology neutrality.
So generally, over the last 10 years, the regulatory and the policy-making decisions, the development of the national ICT policies, regulatory frameworks, and importantly, the consumer experiences are starting to become integrated. So policymakers and regulators must continue to collaborate. Policymakers and regulators must be prepared to take risks, to work outside their core scope of functions, and be open-minded and make improvements throughout the processes.
Today, the world is completely different from 20 years ago. Telecom regulators, although they operate with the same principles, their ability to really contribute to the digital economy today is very limited. They've done their work, they have to keep working on that, but they have to be reinvented completely. One restriction that telecom regulators have today is that the legal framework where they operate is quite old. And today, the regulators of the digital economy are not telecom regulators. Every single regulator or every single sector is an ICT regulator. The health regulator is an ICT regulator. The finance regulator is an ICT regulator. The consumer protection regulator is an ICT regulator. The energy regulator is an ICT regulator. Everybody has to include ICT in the way services are provided to citizens.
What do you think the role of ICT and telecom policymakers and regulators is or should be in privacy and data protection?
There are tools which can and regulations which can be put into place, but nothing can replace education of the consumer. And many regulators are putting a lot of time in working with different entities in educating the consumer in the use and safe access of social media and the internet. So that is a significant role that the regulator is playing with many different other entities. So our whole digital economy relies upon data, relies upon personal data, relies upon e-commerce, and that needs significant cooperation internationally, significant changes in laws in order for that e-commerce to work effectively and safely. And the regulator has a key role to play in coordinating those activities.
Although important discussions and regulatory best practices on matters including data protection and privacy were annually promoted in the last 5 years at the ITU level, the UN IGF forums, and many more regional events, we learned that very few developed countries or economies have at least developed and are developing frameworks that have assisted to signal to many national governments, the telecom operators and the service providers, including the consumers, the need of having a national data protection and privacy. The regulators should once more collaborate with policymakers and other institutions that are promoting data privacy to be more concentrated and move faster.
And the most important thing is that we should be focused on the real gaps of the digital economy. And data protection is not a gap. that we can solve in the developing countries. This is not about local regulation. This is about global regulation. So we should be concerned about joining the global efforts, because the internet doesn't have borders. The internet doesn't have borders. So we have to really do something global. In the case of Colombia, 70% of people are connected to the internet. That's great. But do kids have computers at home to be connected to the school? Do public schools are prepared to teach with these new models? Are the payment systems in place to make sure that the e-commerce works? Is the health system working? Are people using internet in a positive way?
So with that, I am going to close this session. Thank you all very, very much for participating, for getting back together.